Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode on the Entrepreneur Series. We are going on my channel, and today we have Bhagyashree joining in. So Bhagyashree is an entrepreneur, and yeah, so thank you very much for being here. It's my pleasure having you. Thank you.
Thank you, Lakshit. Thanks for having me here today.
My pleasure, my pleasure. So before starting, that would be great if you can just speak about yourself and what you did. That would be amazing.
Okay, so basically, I am an entrepreneur and I work in the waste management field in India. So plastic waste management, which is a really nascent field that has come up in India, but the kind of plastic waste that we're dealing with is humongous. Our country is one of the biggest producers of the plastic waste, and it's a big problem. Also, in the current times, the times of Corona that we are living in, the added problem that we have, which for now maybe like we've put it in back, we are like focusing on the medical side of it. But what we don't realize is, see, we are using gloves, we are using PP kits, we are using masks, which everything is made up of plastic. Even the sanitizers that you're using, so the plastic bottle is there. So what happens once you use them? We throw them away, right? But there is a side to it where somebody has to come into picture who has to deal with this waste. We cannot keep filling our landfills anyway. If you go to Delhi or so I am from Delhi, so I've always seen these humongous landfills filled with waste where the food waste and the plastic waste, the e-waste, everything is just put in one place, which creates a lot of problem for the country in terms of environment, even in terms of economy. So right now, and mostly how we've been functioning is, so every day, I'm sure you and everyone and me, we use so much in terms of plastic in every little thing. A water bottle that we buy, or any food package that you buy, any little thing. Even if you go out, you take a plastic bag to buy some things. But the problem is that because this keeps increasing. Now, in our life, there's so much plastic, but nothing is being done. And for continuous production, it uses energy, right? There's some energy involved, there's manufacturing involved. But now we're continuously just putting, a product, like we're putting in energy, we're producing this plastic, and then plastic does not degrade. And then it just goes into environment. So, we're trying to build two sides of it. One is disposing of the waste plastic in a sustainable manner. And secondly, introducing the recycled plastic, not just the virgin plastic that is used in manufacturing. We're trying to make the brands and the companies change in terms of the plastic that they use. So, I think that gives an idea of what I do.
Okay. And how this all start? Like, how did you start a company which works with plastic and on plastic management? How did it start?
Okay, so we started this company 6 years ago. 6 years ago, and like this was a joint idea with my father. So we've been involved into cloth manufacturing, and we were ourselves using a lot of plastic. But then we were just having a conversation, to be honest, about and we do these plantation drives. We've been doing this as a family for a long time, but then the thought, in just a family discussion, there was this thought that, okay, we're doing our part for the environment by just doing what, by just planting seeds. And we thought that it was not enough, so we started inquiring about recycled plastic, which we could use as packaging. But we had a lot of difficulty in getting the right manufacturers. Then we thought that, okay, if we want to really do it, maybe like we'll have to do a backward integration and start something of ourselves. So that's how we actually started our research into it. And we realized that, two problems can be solved, in one go, that we could actually solve our country's waste problem, plastic waste problem, and produce this recycled plastic granules and resin that we call it, and help other manufacturers as well. So that was the idea 6 years ago, and I think I can proudly say that we've achieved a fair bit of it today.
Okay. And from what do you do of the as you said, you recycle plastic, so what do you do with plastic is recycled?
Okay, so see, how it starts is, firstly, there are two sides of it. Like I said, we recycle industrial plastic as well as we recycle the household and consumer waste, okay? So firstly, there is one waste that, all of us throw out, like rag pickers, when they, collect waste from our households every day. So this plastic waste, Now, what we have done is because we did not want to disrupt the entire the existing ecosystem. So we work in like, you know, parallel with the rag pickers. So we empower them in terms that we've established recycling centers in, currently our recycling centers are in UP, Delhi and Rajasthan now. So we ask them to segregate plastic waste from the food waste and other e-waste and everything. So that plastic waste we buy from them at a higher price. Earlier, matlab jo rag pickers there were, so they were selling it to, say, you know, a bigger kabadi wala, or and the kabadi wala would do something with it, or maybe it would be thrown mostly, like they would take out the useful material like e-waste and metal, and then they would throw this in the landfill. Now we pay them to segregate it and to give it to us. So we buy, so in our plant, there are recycling plants, there is a separate unit for each type of plastic. There are hundreds of types of plastic. Major categories are PET, HDPE, LD, EPS, thermocol, which you call. So we segregate these things, and then there's a separate machine for each type of plastic wherein a different product is produced by that. And so so currently, like for example, thermocol, if you buy any gadget, and I'm sure because you are a podcaster, so you are into technology, you use a lot of equipments. So most of your equipments must come in a thermocol packaging, right?
Yes.
And before, what do you do with that packaging?
We throw it.
You throw it, right? Now, what do you think happens to it? You see it lying around, or maybe it's on landfill. What we do is we get that collected and we turn this thermocol, we recycle it, and it is we make the photo frames that are there in our houses. So we make that photo frame out of it. That's what we've done. So that's called upcycling. So like, that's why we have different process for each type of plastic that is. So we make, like I said, we make photo frames out of it. We make the soles of the shoes out of it. So there are a lot of things that can be upcycled and done with it. Yeah. That's what we do. And similarly with like all types of plastic, there are several uses for each one according to their properties. So that's what we do. And also because I said, so this is a household side of it. For factories, there's a system. So there is a law in India, which not many people are aware of. It's called EPR, which is Extended Producer Responsibility.
Okay.
Now what EPR states is that, okay, so nowadays, all of us are trying to be environment friendly, okay? But the onus is not on us. See, even if as a consumer, you try to, minimize your plastic use, or you try to get it to a recycling center, see, you can do it in a very little amount. The higher onus, the bigger onus is on brands or on the companies or, on the manufacturers. Now, what EPR states is that these companies, these brands are responsible. So whatever amount of plastic they buy for their packaging or for their use, say, for example, a company buys 100 kgs of plastic. According to EPR law, the company is responsible to get that 100 kgs worth of plastic recycled. Now, it can get any, it can get collected. You don't have to particularly go and, collect from road your particular brand. Just get 100 kgs of plastic recycled. That's what the government states, which is, I believe, completely justified. And so that's what we help the brands to do. So in we sign a contract, say, with a certain brand, and on their behalf we do the recycling, or and they pay us for that, for all the process that is, we put our resources in getting it collected, in getting it segregated, then recycling it. So, and then for that particular we work with brands, and then we give them a certification.
Okay.
For that particular month, that okay, this month you used X amount of plastic and we recycled it on your behalf. So that's what we do.
Okay, okay. And what do you also make free the photo frames with all the industrial plastic also? What do you do with that plastic?
Yeah, so like photo frames, and like I said, plus shoelaces, and then there's the, so if you've seen small sheds. So they have this roof, which is like, it looks like kind of tin, but it's actually plastic. So those kind of stuff. So that is like, that's the upcycling. So we use our own recycled produce that we manufacture. We use it into those products. And then there's certain products which are B2B, and some of them are B2C consumer products.
Okay. 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 And what has been a major problem in the journey of 6 years? Like what kind of problems did you see?
See, in In terms of problems, it has been actually really hard because if you see, so earlier there was a nexus of these small rag pickers and kabadi walas, but I wouldn't place the blame on them because see, it's a very backward, you know, society that the environment that they live in. So, you know, for somebody to just come and tell them that, okay, we want to make this process mainstream, it's a little hard for them to believe. Okay. So the main hardship that we faced was getting these people on board. So we had to gain their trust that, you know, we are not here to disrupt your work. We're actually here to empower you. So, you know, to work. So because that's what we wanted to do. So we wanted to work in harmony with them. And that's what finally we've achieved, you know, after a lot of toil and hard work. So that was that. And then also, like, you know, one of the major hardships, which we are still working on, I would say we are not completely there, is we still try to educate people. Because, see, when you throw your waste in India, people still, like, you know, households are still not accustomed or they've not yet learned to segregate their waste. We put all our waste, be it the, you know, wet waste or the dry waste, we put everything in one bin. And when you do that, like, everything gets contaminated. So then segregating and recycling is a huge task. Matlab, it actually takes up a lot of our resources, which, you know, sets us back a lot. So we're actually trying to educate the people not to do that, to, you know, segregate their waste at the first point of interaction with it, to, you know, put your dry waste. And it's not hard. Okay. It's simple, actually. It's just, so if you see the model of Japan, you know, people in Japan are required to segregate their waste in 44 different categories.
Oh, okay.
We are just asking you to do, yeah, we are just asking you to do two, just dry and, like, you know, wet waste, just keep it separate. So that's one. And then, see, Lakshya, there's this one thing that, you know, like I said, the EPR law is there. The law is in place. But like with like everything else in our country, it's very hard to implement it. You know, unless the government forces a brand or a company or a manufacturer to abide by it, they don't want to do it. Because frankly, it's an added cost. Getting your waste recycled is an added cost to them. And they don't want to take that responsibility. They don't want to take that blame. But I mean, so that has been like after working with government, after working with CPCB, with the pollution departments of every state, that has been a very hard road. It's a tiresome process, making people, you know, actually like responsible people to, you know, just come on board and do it. But I would say that, you know, it's worked out. It's working out. There are brands like Whirlpool. Whirlpool is a very responsible brand. So we work with them and they get their entire plastic waste recycled.
Okay.
So there are other brands like which we don't work with. There are other people who work with them. Mama Earth is a very responsible beauty brand. So, I mean, I like to appreciate these brands who are, you know, even if they're not working with us, but other, you know, but at least they're doing their bit. So that's important. The brand Mohan Mekins is a very like amazing brand. So which is a legacy brand, but they decided to, you know, move on with the times. So they were one of the first people to get on board.
Okay.
So yeah.
Okay. Okay. And how does the business model works? Like how business works over here?
Okay, to give you a bigger picture of it, so there are two major sides of it. One is collection center and one is the plant. Okay, so the plant is where, you know, recycling happens. Now, plant can be like, you know, you can make multiple plants in terms of you can have multiple plants for different types of plastics, given that, you know, you have that kind of quantity and it also depends on the kind of space that you have. Okay, also, there is the rule that, for example, there are it depends on state by a different state. For example, in Delhi, you cannot put such a plant in the center of the city. So we have our plant in the outskirts. Similarly, in UP, so mostly in industrial areas. So you set up these plants. Also, it helps because then you're in vicinity of other companies and, you know, you can get their plastic waste. So that is one side of it. The second side of it is the collection centers, which can be, you know, there all over the, like, you know, all over the city, all over a state that, you know, wherever you're working. So that's the second part. So basically how largely the process works is it gets collected, the waste gets collected, it gets segregated into different types. And then according to that particular type, it is sent to the plant where it is recycled, upcycled, or, you know, it's down, there is the other process downgrading, or the process that, you know, there's another process in existence, which is called waste to energy. wherein you convert the, but the problem with that process is, although it sounds really good that, you know, maybe we could have an alternate fuel, which we hope, let's, you know, that we can have that in future. But for now, the process majorly involves incineration, which is, okay, in simpler terms, burning.
Okay.
So with burning, you produce energy. But if you look at it, as of now, it's not really helpful for the environment, because then you're releasing gases like, you know, monoxides. So that's kind of a process that, you know, I don't personally advocate for. So yeah, but yeah, slowly and steadily. So, I mean, if you segregate the waste and then, you know, that's how it works.
Okay. Okay. Wonderful. Wonderful. And what did you learn from this journey? Like, what kind of things did you learn and get to know?
So like I said, okay, so the first thing, I have always been like, you know, for environment. Okay. I genuinely believe that, you know, whatever, it's sometimes frustrating that, you know, today, whatever environment that we live in, I come from Delhi. Okay. Delhi is one of the worst, like, polluted cities, like in the world, in the entire world. Okay. And it really frustrates me that we inherited it from our parents or the generation before that, and they did not care for our planet. I mean, not to, like, you know, sound like Greta Thunberg from India, but I mean, but whatever she said, it's true. Okay, this okay, it was their responsibility, but now we are the present and the future of this country. So I genuinely believe that it is our responsibility that at least when we pass on this planet, we pass it on, you know, making it a little better. So my learning has been that, you know, since I was in school, we were taught that, okay, you know, there used to be plantation drives, you know, we used to clean the, you know, the waste from, you know, we went on these different drives in our school. I'm sure a lot of kids, you know, they do that. I'm sure you would have done it in school, right? But once you get into it and once you start learning, you realize, okay, there has to be done. You have to do more. This doesn't stop here. The bug doesn't stop here. Then, you know, maybe like read a little more, research a little more that, okay, what else can I do? So nowadays I'm very happy. So a lot of my friends and maybe like extended friends and even a lot of people from Instagram, so when they read my bio and they see, okay, I work with a waste management company, they personally call me. I receive so many messages telling them, okay, I have this much waste collected in my house. Can you please take this plastic waste? I don't want to throw it away. And I love it, you know, when people genuinely, like, you know, it hurts them. Like, they feel hurt. I don't want to throw it in the, you know, streets again. I don't want to get it polluted, like, get the environment polluted. So that has been a major learning for myself. And, like, you know, seeing the change coming in the country, in the people, in the youngsters especially. Also, there has been a learning that, you know, nowadays, so I was just recently reading about somebody on LinkedIn who posted a story that they did an MBA from, you know, one of the Ivy League colleges. And now that person wants to work in the sustainability sector.
Okay.
So I was reading this person's interview and, you know, he said that, you know, what will I do? Like, okay, I can get a very like high corporate job and everything. But what about the future? Like, I mean, he said that, you know, it actually irritated him to think about future that, okay, I may have a lot of money, but where will I use it? Like right now in Corona, we are just sitting at home, right?
Yeah.
So he said that I want to build a better future. So I think like that has been a learning that, yes, even I want to do something like that. That's, you know, what I'm living for. So, yeah.
Okay. And what would be your advice for anybody who wants to start their own sustainable company?
I would advise that I'm in the process of launching of a business, like, you know, wherein we're actually working on, seriously, so we are working on this franchising model. Because, see, one of the hurdles that is that the technology in our country, you can look up different technologies that is, you know, present abroad in different countries. But the thing is that different systems work for different countries. So initially when we were looking for technologies, which was like, I forgot to mention this when you asked the questions about hurdles. So the problem is that, you know, the machines that were available, they were not actually very well suited for Indian environment. So for the kind of plastic waste that we generate, because like I said, it's contaminated and then, like, you know, every country has a different kind of waste as well. So the machines that were available in the market, they were not very well suited. So it was very interesting. We actually built our own machine. We worked with a lot of, like, you know, developers, we worked with scientists, and, you know, we worked with researchers that, okay, what can be the best machine for India? So we worked on that. And so currently, now we are in the system of building a franchise model wherein we can replicate our existing system that already we know that works. We've, you know, perfected it over years. So now you can just, I mean, work with us and replicate it in different cities wherever, you know, you want to. So yeah, my best suggestion would be, yeah, work with us.
Wonderful. Yeah. Thank you. And before ending this session, what would you like to add a message, or what kind of things would you like to add up before ending this?
I would just say, see, because the current times that we've experienced, the times of Corona, this has come from a place where, you know, we have interfered with the environment, where we've interfered with the ecology, which we shouldn't have, which we do not have the right to. So my suggestion, or maybe take it as a request or anything, is please care for the environment that, you know, you live in, that you survive on, because this is what, you know, we have. This is, and this is the only planet that we have. Elon Musk is far from sending all of us, you know, on the moon or on the Mars or wherever, you know, you think that, you know, a second planet and you can go on. We're far from that. And considering the population of our country, like, your chances are really less. So at least from an Indian perspective, I would say, and it's really high time that we do. So like I said, because I come from Delhi, I know what it feels to live in a bad environment, in an environment where the air is highly polluted. You know, it's not okay. Every day you will deal with little problems, see people suffer with like, you know, breathing problems. Then us girls, we have this major issue of skin problems. No matter how much, you know, skincare you do, it's actually better if you care for the environment. You wouldn't have to invest in these things. So for everything, yeah, just really care for, you know, if you, as much as you care for your home that you live in, do care for the planet.
Okay. Yeah. Wonderful. Yeah. A wonderful session. And thank you very much for being here. It was a pleasure having you. Thank you.
Thank you. Love being here. Yeah.